Hello friends, welcome back. My name is Priyendra Kumar. In this video, you will learn how we can create names in Microsoft Excel quickly using VBA. So here, as you are seeing my screen, I have this data available in this sheet 1. This is available in book 1. Here I have month, day, week number and the supervisor names and the employee which are coming under particular supervisor. Now I have to create the names for each column which can be used in any dashboard or any report. You need to go to the formula and you will click on name manager or define name. Then you will select the range. Then you will click on OK. So the first name is created for month, you can see here. Then you will create the next name and you will put the name, let's say day, and then you will select the respective range from here. If you have the hundreds or the thousand column and you have to create the names, it will take a lot of time to create this. So let me delete these name and tell you how can you quickly create these name. I have selected this range and on the formulas tab, I have created a new button which is create quick names. If I will click here, then it's done. Now I'll go to the name manager. You can see all the names have been created automatically and it took less than 1 second for 10 names. Now I'll show you the range. It has picked up the dynamic range. You can select any of the name from here. You can see the selection. Let's say for month, let's say for day, or any of the supervisor also. Now I'll tell you how can you add this create quick names button in your Excel ribbon. So I'm going to the developer tab and then I will click on Visual Basic. Here I will create a macro in personal.xlsv. If your personal.xlsv is not visible in your Visual Basic editor window, then you can enable this. So I'll tell you how can you enable this. First of all, you need to go to the developer tab or in view tab. Then you just need to go to the macros and click on record macro. Then you can see a drop down is available, store macro in. Currently it is personal macro, or in your Excel it may be this workbook or new workbook. Make sure you have selected personal macro workbook and just click on OK. Then immediately go back to the macros in view tab and then click on stop macro. Now if you will go to the developer tab and Visual Basic, your personal.xlsv will be available, and in the module there will be one module available. This is the module which I have already created, but this is the new module. This macro just we have recorded because we have not recorded any action, so it is blank. Now we will put our code inside this macro. Just delete this. You can rename this macro, let's say create quick names. Now here I am taking dim RNG as range and I will set RNG equal to selection. Whatever will be the selection, that will be my RNG. Alright. And I'll take few variables here like dim new range as range. Then I'll take dim I as integer, dim n as long. Then I'll take dim. Here I have taken the first row as long, last row as long, and the column number as integer. So these are the variables which we will use in our code. Now here I will put a loop. So I'll use for I equal to, and I will put the loop from 1 to whatever the number of columns are available in our selection, and our selection was RNG. RNG dot columns dot count. Here we will put next I. Then we will put another loop inside this loop. So I'll use for n equal to, but this time we will put a loop for the rows. We will put a loop from the last row to first row. So what I will do here, I will use rng.rows.count to 1, and here I will use step minus 1. Alright, because we are stepping from last to 1, next n. So first of all, we will assign the first row, last row and column number. The first row will be in our selection RNG dot, I'll use row number rows dot, and then I'll take the first row in RNG and whatever the row number. So we will assign to first row. For the last row, we will use RNG dot rows. Then because we have put the loop from last row to first row, So this last row will change every time rng.rows and n.row, and then we will assign the column number. Column number will be rng dot, here we will use columns and have already used one loop for column, so the number will be I dot column. This will be our column number. Alright, so what I'm going to do, so let me explain you. First of all, let's say I'm creating the name for first range. I have selected this, then my last row will be this, and I'm creating the name for column number A. Then I'll check this cell first. If it is blank, then I will check this, then this, until I will get the values. As soon as I will get this cell which have some value, then I will consider the range from A1 to A13. Alright, so we have to find out this range, and then that range we will assign to new range. Alright, so first of all, we will put a if condition. If cells, then I will use row number. So row number, we will take the last row because we want to check the value of last cell. Row, comma, column number will remain same in every condition, which is column number, and dot value. If this value is not equal to blank, then only this code should run. If it is not blank, that means we have found the last value, then in that case we will set our new range. This new range variable we have taken, so our new range will be, and here we will use range. Inside the range we will use cells. We will give the first cell and the last cell, then it will be assigned to new range. Okay, so first cell will be, we will use cell, row number we will use here first row, and column number every time will remain same column number. This column number will be changed once this I loop will run. So here we will use the column number. So this is our first cell. Then we will use last cell. Last cell we will use last row, comma, we will take column number. Just close this. So this is our new range, and now we will create the name for this new range. So we will use new range dot create names, and here we will take top equal to true because we are creating the name for top to bottom. So we will use top equal to true. Alright, so automatically for the first cell in the range it will take name, and rest it will be range. Once we have created the name for one column, this name is created, then we should exit from the second for loop, which is the n for loop. This loop we will exit from here, and we will run the loop for next column. Now here I will use message box, that is, let's say done. Now if I will run this, let me go to the formula bar and name manager. First of all, I will delete these name, delete, and close this. If I will run this macro here, select the personal.xlsv. So this is, we are just creating create quick names. If I will run this, done. Now let me see. Yes, it's working. You can select any of the name, you can see the range, it's working. Now I will tell you how can you add this button in the ribbon. So let's say I'm going to add this in home here. So go to the Excel option, go to the file and click on option, then go to the customize ribbon. Here just decide in which tab you want to add this, or you can add your new tab also, just click on new tab. But I will add this button in home tab. So here I will add a new group, click on new group. So this new group is added, just right click and rename this, and just rename this as, let's say, create quick name. Alright, now here in this drop down I will select macros, and here in the personal macros, this is the macro which we are creating, create quick name, and click on add. So this is available here. Now right click on this, you can rename this because it will not look proper. You can simply keep the name as click to create name. You can select any icon also, the relevant icon, whatever you want to select. Let's say I'm just selecting this smiley face, okay, and just click on OK. Now on the home tab you can see one new group is available, create quick name, and here this button is available, click to create quick names. Now let me copy this data. I will add a new workbook here. This is book 3, you can see this is new workbook, and I have pasted this data here.
If you will go to the formula bar, of course there will not be any name available, right? Now I'll tell you from the starting, I will select this and I will go to the home. If I will click here, the name is created. Now I'll go to the formula bar, name manager, multiple names will be here. Alright friends, so that is how you can create the quickly names and you can customize your ribbon also. Friends, you can save the time using this trick. If you don't have the time to creating such tricks in your ribbon, you can use our PK's utility tool version 1.0. Here I have given the multiple features, and if I will show you in the new workbook, I have already given create names button here. You can create the names from here and you can see process completed and the names is available here. Alright, you can use the other features also. This is absolutely free utility tool. You can download it from our website. Download link has been given in video's description box. I hope you have enjoyed this video. Friends, if you like this video, please hit the like button and please subscribe our channel to get the regular updates of our new videos. Thank you so much for watching.